it aloud.
My father, my father.
Shout it aloud.
My father, my father.
Shout it aloud.
My father, my father.
The man of God placed his head between the thighs and bowed down his head, closed his eyes. Means I'm refusing to be distracted by the outside senses and concentrating on the inner side. And to know that my focus is on God. And it is He who has promised. And He also. If you will be listening to criticism and people who doesn't like you, as a matter of fact, even Jesus has enemies. So don't be surprised if somebody hates you. But it is not the person who bless you. And God will not even consult your past to be telling your future. So He placed His head between her laps. Close her ears from what people are saying. The servant will come and say, I don't see anything. And say, go back. I don't see anything. Go back. I don't see anything. And for the seventh time, and say, I see.
I will see.
If you can see.
I will see.
If you can see.
I will see.
If you can see.
I will see.
Say, I see.
I see.
As we sit down here, I see a greater church.
Amen.
I said it in the Easter Convention. I can see a generation of PIWC coming up.
Amen.
That the world cannot hold back.
Amen.
That lies cannot overtake them.
No.
That opposition cannot overtake them.
Amen.
They are going to move with unlimited power,
amen,
unlimited resources,
amen,
anointing that is breaking through,
amen,
shocks that are being broken,
amen,
and people cannot handle you because the world has never known you. Somebody say, I can see.
I can see.
I see a little cloud like a small finger. And said, the little thing that you have seen, it is abundance of rain.
Yes.
Let it rain.
Let it rain.
And for our ministry for 3 years here, there's going to be abundance of rain.
Amen.
After Jesus' 3 years ministry on earth, ministering to the people, after that there's abundance of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
If you can see, if you can see, somebody is catching an anointing of your body. Receive the miracle. Receive the miracle. That tomorrow by this time, I will let him become like the people he had killed. And because Elijah was a man like you and I, he was afraid. He was not a superhuman being. He's just ordinary person by carrying the unction. You see, but we need to remind ourselves every time of God's protection, of God's unction, of God's power concerning our life, so that we stand. The Bible says, having done all this, stand therefore. Don't back up. Stand therefore. So Elijah was discouraged. And he had to run a day's journey. And he was so tired. He left his prophets there and went another extra day's journey and sat down discouraged. How do I do the Lord's work and people are coming to kill me? Wicked people. He didn't know that the protection of God is ever sure. Is ever sure. Though I walk through the valleys and the shadows of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Isaiah 43 says, if you go through the fire, I will be with you. If you go through the waters will not overwhelm you. Since you are precious in my sight, I have called you by my name. I have called you by name. You see, your calling is by name.
Amen.
God didn't call the name, but he knows you by name. And everyone who is called by my name,
amen,
I have created him for my glory.
Amen.
And then, so perplexed, he sat down and was asleep. And an angel of the Lord came. The word angel can be interpreted as an apostle. It's the same word. Malaika, an angel of the Lord, appeared and touched him, not knowing the angel has picked bread from above.
Amen.
I pray that some of you will eat the food of angels.
Amen.